I was at Mohegan Sun Casino, and I was performing, and it was going, like, not great. This is a lot of years ago when I was terrible. I mean, I'm great now. I mean,
that's so humble of you.
No,
yeah.
It was bad, but it was going bad. And these two couples in the front row, and they looked like the guys were tough, like maybe like organized criminals of some kind. And and they were with their dates, and they just kept talking during the show. Like, they just wouldn't stop. And I don't. You know, I don't have, like, heckler lines. Like, I'm not, like, one of those people, comics, who's like, hey, don't, you know, I don't show up at your job and do it poorly. I don't know what the lines
that's
are.
A good, that's a good one.
I don't
that's
have a, lines
no, that's a great
like
one.
That.
Well, now you do. I don't show where you're working. Do that
And do
thing.
It not,
yeah,
as,
not
well
as well
as others.
Yeah. So they're talking during the show.
So, and I go, hey, maybe you guys should leave with your dates, who I implied were hookers. And I'm dead wrong in this situation. By implied, I mean I said maybe you should leave with your hookers. Now, here's where there's so many reasons why this was a bad idea.
Yeah.
Well, there's only two possible scenarios in this instance. One is that they are hookers.
Yeah, that's true. Right? Yeah, I didn't think about that.
If you think
yeah.
about it, they are or they aren't.
Yeah.
If they aren't, it's offensive. Because, you know, they got dressed up. They're like, oh, we're going out with these guys who might be mobsters. And then a person says an insulting thing. And then if they are hookers, it's insulting. Because I think part of the magic of being a great hooker is it's sort of, it's the effortless quality.
Yeah.
Where people are like, is that even a hooker? Who cares? And so I say this, the one guy looks at me dead in the eyes, like dark black eyes. Yeah. This is how I remember it. And he goes, can I curse?
Sure.
We'll bleep it, I'll do both. I'll do a version of both.
Yeah.
He goes, I'm gonna kill you.
Yeah, okay, good. I love that camera got it. I didn't even block your mouth.
I
blocked your mouth here.
I love that this is the level of technology we're working with. Welcome to the Merv Griffin Show.
Show.
Because I'm gonna kill you.
Yeah.
And that wasn't a joke at all.
No.
No one was laughing.
No.
I definitely wasn't laughing. I was thinking about how maybe I could have been a great middle school English teacher.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's perfect for you.
And
guys,
you gotta listen to the end. My brother Joe and I were playing blackjack later that night. My brother Joe was like, Mike, you can't do that. You can't call people's wives hookers. And I go, I know, I was there also. And these two women came over to the blackjack table. I swear this is true. And they said, you guys looking for dates? Well, guess what? They were the same two women from the show.
You were right.
And they were
you were right, yes. You have a right to say that. You were right the whole time.
And as we had sex with those hookers...
No, Mike, that's not true. That's not true. Hey, guys, Mike Birbiglia.